specializing in sales, service, and leasing of heavy trucks. Currently lives on a ranch in Black Hills, South Dakota with his lovely wife, Bonnie. He likes to fish, hunt, and occasionally, and I can testify to this, will have an adult beverage. I have all of you, Oldsmobile, and this wonderful region, John Brown.
should, or there'd still be Oldsmobile. I don't know which. But it deserves a lot of credit for taking the Olds collection, raising it up a standard, and making it available for meetings and stuff like this. These guys, doing stuff like that. And I might add that if you went up to Rick Wagner's office, he's the chairman and CEO, and asked him how much time and money and effort you put on preserving the history of General Motors, I don't think he probably knows the answer to that, and that's good for you and I. Because he's doing a good job, and that is important to our history. Well, this old cowboy gets asked a lot of questions, whether I'm in a saloon in Rapid City or got a board meeting in Texas. But the most often asked question I've had lately is, who done it? Who shot your horse? Well, car company, and needed a little more pizzazz also on the sports car side. I knew that we had nearly a billion and a half dollar capital committed to that whole new Oldsmobile line from Aurora's up to the new provider. So I knew if we went in there and said we want to build a two-seater, these the Corvette people get all tense and puffy, and that it just creates confusion to hell and whatever. So I said, we'll do it in the shortcut. It's like, how old is Carol Shelby? And Carol had fleeced just about every manufacturer in the business. He'd go like through Ford, he'd come through Chrysler, and he said, Carol, how about doing one last car? And I said, I know that your wallet's going to stay in your ass back pocket, so we ain't talking money. We're just talking, we need your name, your reputation, and your manners. I said, here's how we can do it. We'll build two automobile show cars in the Detroit Auto Show. We'll put the Aurora engine in there, we'll give us a carbon fiber body and tune her up. And we'll have these babies, and I said, I think after the show circuit is over, I can get enough old dealers to kick in where we pre-sell 10 cars apiece. We'll sell the franchise for 50 grand, and then we'll have them each put $10,000 apiece down on five cars, so we'll get them for 100 grand apiece. So if we get 50 dealers, we got us a little walk around, change, buy some parts, get some room, breathe room, get some car going there. So we proceeded to do that. And there were those on the Oldsmobile payroll that thought this was just a touch risky. Because when you do a program like that, there are no approvals. You don't tell anybody. You just kind of just say it to your peers, and you say, you know about that? Not me, boss. at any rate, we proceed. And we get the dealer signed up. We get the money. And of course, about this time, that's when I got thrown out of the building. And so all the naysayers, they didn't know what the hell to do or where to go or where I went. But at any rate, there were enough guys in the trenches that kept this thing going. And they actually got a car running in the building. And we were going to do this pretty clever. We were going to put the plant out of the Las Vegas Motor Speedway, which was brand new. They agreed to give us some space. We were going to use Nevada State prisoners to build it so we didn't have any labor cost. got room now for one more division. It's called the Shelby Oldsmobile class, and you know, there's room for about four or five members. It'd be a small but loyal group, but it would be fun to have one of those cars kind of parked up here in the collection. So that would be good. Anyhow, I don't know, there are probably a few country music fans out here, and you're all familiar with Alan Jackson. And he's got the one song, you know, that says there was murder committed down on Music Road. Well, who killed country music? Well, that gets back down to that original premise. Who done it?
They got my initials on here, J.D. Doc. They're made by
working my feet up, and I said, Bob, don't see anything different. She said, no. So, comes time to go to bed. I thought, well, this is it now. So I go walking into the bedroom, cooks start making nothing but my 80 little boots. I said, Bob, do you see anything different? She said, no. She said, I'm not impressed with that damn little thing hanging down there. I said, well, the reason that damn old thing is hanging down there is because it's looking at my brand new name.
Interested people here in Lansing that it would be worth it.
grab the ball